is raw.
What the fuck was that?
Oh, they're just like kidnapping the women because aliens have a stake in Earth ladies.
Wasn't that like a thing? Like they use women for their awful birthing programs?
I don't fucking know. I guess that was kind of implied in the Duke Nukem 3D, but you know, that's not exactly a game you go to like to get a story. Like, you know,
it's I remember they had those horrifying like fucking women in those birthing pods, and it was just like, holy fuck, this is raw.
This game takes it actually like in the first game it wasn't as, you know, like, it's just basically a callback to the Alien films.
Yeah.
In this game, they actually take it to, like, a sexual degree, and that's where it starts getting a little bit cringy, you know what I mean? Like, it implies Alien space rape, and it's just, you know, not very well thought out at all, and it's...
Like, okay, so, I always have, like, a bit of a thing on this. In, like, a lot of movies, or, like, a lot of media, you'll see, like, oh, there's alien parasites that need people for reproduction.
Right.
And, like, there are different ways it can be handled. There's, like, the Alien franchise, for example, which handles it uniquely, where it's, like, they are a parasite.
Yeah.
Then there's, like, in Warhammer 40K, they have the Tyranids.
Right.
And the Tyranids' entire thing is that they integrate the DNA and, like, strong traits of other races into their own to become, like, an omni-race.
Okay.
Like, they're a horrifying, like, swarm of terrifying psychic monsters, but they keep getting stronger the more unique traits they devour. So to that end, they have a thing called the Gene Stealer. And what this is like, it was heavily influenced by the Xenomorph, and like, if you ever see a picture of a Gene Stealer, like, you would not be surprised by this.
Okay.
But the entire thing is, like, they are described as having what's called an ovpositor. Oh my god, you're actually gonna drive off her ass. What's called an ovpositor, which is totally a thing, which is a organ where you lay an egg inside other things.
Right, right.
So, like, in canon, what they do is they take, like, random citizens they find, and they inject them with the ovpositor, and turn them, like, repurpose your sexual organs to give birth to their terrible monster babies. But they also psychically fuck with you, so you love your horrible mutant baby. And then this horrible mutant baby will proceed to have more rape babies, and then it just turns into an entire infestation of horrifying inbred monsters.
Are you going anywhere with this? Where's this going?
My entire point being that there's actually some times when, like, space rape can be, like, a very almost interesting and unique thing. And then there's Duke Nukem, where it's just like, yeah, isn't that hot? And it's like, nah, man, when you actually put science behind it, you can make some genuinely terrifying things.
Yeah, you can totally have a whole body horror thing going on.
Like, that's the thing. Like, the Gene Stealer thing is body horror, because when you see them, like, each successive generation is more alien and horrible than the last. And, like, that's sort of the point. Like, they're monsters. But, like, in this, Duke Nukem, it's just like, yeah, hot women getting raped by my... And it's like that weird fetish that you see a lot of, where it's just like ugly guys fucking hot women, and it's like, I don't get it. Like, I genuinely don't.
I don't think I was supposed to exit the car.
No, I don't believe you were.
How did I exit the car? Oh my god.
It seemed to have crashed.
I thought that was supposed to happen.
You played this!
I know, and for some reason, I'm just having like, I forget everything. Yeah. I don't
know. Did my talk of alien rape just confuse you?
Well, I was trying to pay attention, but I was just like, does it have a point? Is it just like talking? Does she know I'm still here? Like,
yeah, well, I mean...
Wait a minute. Wait, this is definitely...
This is magic. Anyway, my point being that, like, there's two ways to go about it. You can have, like, the horror aspect where, like, the people are breeding sows and they don't know what's going on and they're just, like, you know, there's horror to it. There's psychological, biological horror. Then you have this, where it's clearly just, isn't that funny and kind of hot?
Yeah. Well, those are like the lines of dialogue. I forget exactly what the women who are in the thing say, but it kind of implied like, oh, Duke, we got pregnant, so are we, and it's just like, ugh, like, you know. Yeah, no, this game didn't handle a lot of things well and controversial topics, but to be fair, We don't know who to blame for that kind of tasteless part, because we can't tell if it was the 3D Realm.
Well, no, like, that's the thing. Like, you can, like, that tastelessness has always been in the franchise, but it was a lot more tongue-in-cheek before. And in this one in specific, it's gone from tongue-in-cheek to just being kind of like, that just didn't look good.
But, you know,
it went from being tongue-in-cheek to being, like, kind of obnoxious. Like, it went from, like, you know, being, like, an actual aspect of Duke Nukem, which was, like, cringeworthy, but to the point of being humorous. Whereas now, it's just, like, recent Family Guy levels of cringe, where it's just like, like no one's having fun.
But you know what, though? I actually disagree. Duke Nukem, I actually think, used to be really tasteful. I think it got tasteless. Like, the thing is, they just mishandled a franchise that had a lot of potential. Because, like, Duke Nukem 3D came out in a really good time and place where, you know, that kind of game
wasn't that common, right?
You know?
I would argue that it wasn't tasteful, it was tasteless, but it was, like, acceptably so.
But
like,
it
didn't, like, oh, what the fuck? Why are you jumping like that?
Because you're landing on a bar stool, and I guess that makes you bounce. Don't question it. Don't.
I am genuine. Okay.
Let's just go with it. This is not the weirdest thing you're going to see all day. Oh, no. Did I just fuck this up?
Just enter the fire.
The sweet release of death.
Only there it goes.
Oh, whoa. Wow,
that was a thing.
Well, I was going to say, this game...
That was cool.
Good Duke Nukem games are no more tasteless or tasteful than, per se, like, a Total Recall or a Starship
Troopers. No, I was
saying,
like...
Right? They're satirical, especially,
no,
like,
they're satirical, but, like, that's the thing. Like, they're the same level of tasteless jokes, but there's a more tongue-in-cheek and innocent feel to it. Like, Duke Nukem in the good games... He's more of a, I wouldn't say an everyman, but he's like, he's more genuine. He's more like, he's not just no, like, I don't mean like, you know, genuine versus sarcastic, but I mean like, the jokes he's making and the stuff he's doing are more for the sake of making and doing jokes, as opposed to this game where it's just like, yeah, Duke Nukem, yeah, he likes butts, yeah.
Well, this game specifically, I definitely agree, is very, like, crass and
yeah,
tasteless.
Yeah, like,
but
well, no, he's
so
always been
3D.
Crass and tasteless, but, like, in 3D, there was a charm to it. Like, that's what I'm saying. Like, this game lacks the charm that they had.
But
like,
I think charm
I
is
mean,
a...
For fuck's sake, you could throw cash at naked strippers and they'll get more naked somehow.
No, I'm with you, but hear me out on this one. Like, I think... being charming is actually a sign of good taste, and knowing,
yeah,
like, you know, when to draw the line, and knowing when to, like, you know, hold back on certain elements, right? I think, like, Duke Nukem 3D, that's why that game is what it is. It's very humorous, because it knew when to, like, take itself, well, not seriously, but knew when to,
yeah,
like, you know,
but
pull
like,
its punches, right?
Well, what I mean about this game is, like, in the old Duke Nukem games, he wasn't, like, the savior of Earth. He was just Duke Nukem,
no,
and
he was.
Just... Well, no, I mean, like,
this game takes it to, like, an obnoxious degree, for sure.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, in this game, Duke Nukem is actually, like, a Jesus figure, and, like, there is a cult of personality surrounding him. Whereas in the other games, it's just Duke Nukem is saving Earth. Like, it's not Duke Nukem the savior of Earth, it's Duke Nukem the character saving Earth.
That, I'll give you, that's a good point. I'll
like,
I'll
that's why I feel like this game feels less genuous, like...
Sorry, disingenuous, you mean?
Yeah, less genuous. Like, it doesn't feel genuine.
I don't think genuous is a word.
Yeah, probably.
I'm sorry, I'm nitpicking speech. I didn't mean to. You're right. Just go.
You know what I mean. Like, okay.
I don't
you know what?
Know
you
what
cleared
that.
The jump.
Okay.
And the pig man just lost interest. Anyway, my point was that, like, in those other games, like, it was more genuine. Like, you know, you weren't playing, like, this.
Let's just say a demigod.
Yeah.
For all intents and purposes.
Like, the game didn't, like, make Duke Nukem out to be this... Oh, is that supposed to happen?
Yeah, it was. Okay. I was like, that's why I almost feel like it's not going to make it. As you can tell, I land on the very edge.
But yeah, like...
Yeah, you know, the thing about it, too, is, like... This game... I think that was the attempt of being self-aware, was making the whole demigod Duke thing, where it's like, oh, you know, notice how video game action characters are perfect, and they always get their shit together, and you always get everything done just the way it's supposed to be, and, like... But the problem about that is this game lacks self-awareness in the parts that it could have taken the piss out of more. I like the idea of, like, Duke being a demigod. I actually am okay with that, but it's just, like, everything around that. Because I think it's charming that you're going to the hotel and, like, there's all these posters of you and, like...
Well, look, clearly this is the Duke Nukem Hotel, but I mean, like, that's what I liked about the other games was there wasn't all this, like, him being Duke Nukem. Like... Like, that's the thing, like...
You're definitely absolutely right about that.
You know what? I would think that putting bulletproof glass in the shark tank in a place frequented by Duke Nukem makes a lot of sense. That just seems like a good choice at their part. Like,
oh yeah.
Let's not tempt fate and have Duke Nukem fucking flood this room with sharks.
But let's be honest, even...
But no, that's what I mean. Like, that's the difference I feel.
No, you know, you're absolutely right in some respects. Like, I think, like... Duke Nukem 3D isn't really that funny, but what it does is that it doesn't take itself seriously.
Yeah, no, but
it,
like, yeah, that's the thing. Like, he doesn't expect to be. Like, he's making references to 80s movies, and that kind of makes him not seem like this, like, impossible demigod figure. It makes him seem like a fucking dork.
Yeah,
and that's
yeah.
charming. Like, in this, though, he's just like, yeah, I'm the greatest thing since sliced bread. Everybody wants to suck my nuclear dick.
Well, in this world, they literally do, so...
Yeah, and, like, that's the thing. Like, it was better when no one... Like, Duke Nukem was just the only person there. Not, like, this be-all, end-all. Like, Duke... Like, I liked it better when Duke Nukem wasn't, like, the ideal. He was just what we had.
But you know what, though? The thing about this... I can't even believe I'm about to say this, but this game's idea was way ahead of its time. The idea that Duke being a demigod... I almost think that's, like, a... If this game were to come out today, I feel they would have gone for that approach. They would have made a game
well,
where, like, it's, like, Duke Nukem is, like, you know, this fake demigod, and that people love him, and...
I was gonna say, like, there's two ways to do it. Like, there's this game where, like, everyone plays it up, and even Duke is just up his own ass. And then there's in Doom 4, where it's less that Doom Guy was hyping himself up. The hype existed, because the meme of Doom Guy existed. The game was just playing off the meme.
But you know
it
what?
Wasn't hyping up the meme any further. It was already there. They were just using it. And that's the difference. Like,
also, I think there's more to it, though. I think with the Doom guy specifically, he's a guy who's on a job. His job being that he's a space marine or the fuck... I forgot what the organization
Well, I mean, it's not just that. Like,
whereas
I mean,
Doom is practically... Doesn't like, you know, like, what is Duke Nukem? Is he a soldier? Is he an agent? Is he... Like, what's his deal? He's just
like,
guy who's really buff.
Duke Nukem,
kicks ass, right?
Well, that's the thing. Duke Nukem is just like...
So that's why I'm saying, like, the Doom guy, at least, you can, like, argue that it would not make sense if a faceless Marine was a celebrity, right? Because, again, he's just, like, he's a guy who has
a job
to do.
Well, that's the thing. Like, he's not a celebrity. Like, even in the universe, he's not a celebrity. In the meme, he's not a celebrity. What Doom guy is in the meme is Doom guy is Doom guy. The most unstoppable, like, he's the thing that hell is scared of. And, like, there's a difference there where it's, like, you know... No one tells you this. Like, he doesn't tell you this. It's explored as a reality of the universe. That Doom Guy is a universal constant. That for as long as hell exists, there is a Doom Guy. And hell doesn't like that.
Yeah, yeah.
And, like, the difference between that and Duke Nukem telling you this is that Duke, like, you know, the universe, like, Duke Nukem... goes around and says, I'm the biggest dick in town. Whereas Doom Guy just is, and you're expected to, like, you know, acknowledge that the realistic way of just, like, okay, so it turns out 80% of hell was killed by Doom Guy. Okay, he's a badass. As opposed to Doom Guy being like, hi, I'm Doom Guy. I'm a badass.
Well, Duke Nukem in this game is kind of like the Tony Stark of video game characters.
Well, like, Tony Stark had class. Like, Duke fundamentally lacks class.
Well, I think they both do. Like, you know, like, I would party with Tony Stark and Duke Nukem. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah, no,
like,
they'd
you know,
be, like, there, yeah, but that's the thing. Like, Tony Stark is, like, an asshole, but he has redeeming features.
And so is Duke Nukem. He saved the fucking world.
Yeah,
sure,
but like... I mean, like, he does it like an asshole. Like,
yeah, yeah, but so is Tony Stark. Like, he's not exactly, like, a nice dude. Like,
no, but I mean, he has his heart in the right place. Like, Tony Stark
does
is saving...
He?
Tony Stark is not saving the world for the fame or for the fucking money. He already has the money. Tony Stark is saving the world because it's the right thing to do, and he acknowledges that.
But do you
He acknowledges he's flawed as well. Like, he admits, like, okay, yeah, Ultron, I fucked that up. Okay, yeah, the superhero registration thing, in retrospect, a bad idea.
That's true, but, like, I think it's also fair to say that, like, even, you know, Iron Man is a very fleshed-out, well-made character, whereas Duke Nukem was always supposed to be, like, a parody. Like, he was never supposed to have any form of depth, so, like...
Yeah, but that becomes the problem here, where you're doing, like, this... Like, you know, in old style games where there's not a lot of... Like, old Duke Nukems, there's not a lot of dialogue.
There's no dialogue.
Yeah, so him not having a personality is fine. I think the fact that you're in a first-person game now, and he won't shut the fuck up, makes his lack of a personality more egregious.
Albeit he did, like, throw a lot of quips in Duke Nukem 3D. Maybe, like, there wasn't any, like, he didn't react to, like, what happened. Like,
no, like, you know, that's the thing. Like, it's just quips. Like, like I said, like, there's a dorkiness to it when he does it in Duke Nukem 3D, where it's just like, I'll be back, baby. And you're just like, oh, okay, he's doing the Schwarzenegger thing. I get it. And, like, that's the thing. Back then, that kind of made it, like, charming, because his personality was kind of dorky.
Well, think about, like,
as opposed to now, where he's just an asshole.
I think he always kind of was, though, like...
Yeah, he always was an asshole, but, like, again, there is a certain amount of charm in that like, dorky personality he had. Like, he wasn't as much of a badass Superman as he was, like, kind of just the guy doing the shit, and he's a bit of a dork.
You know, I kind of appreciate.
Like,
I'm
harping on that, but it's because I really genuinely like that idea better, that Duke Nukem is this, like, movie nerd who finally got the chance to live out those action movies, and he just happens to be good at it. Let's rock!